dwarf lords in their halls of stone. Nine for mortal men doomed to die. One for the Dark Lord on his dark throne in the land of Mordor, where the shadows lie. One ring to rule them all. One ring to find them. One ring to bring them all, and in the shadows bind them, in the land of Mordor, where the shadows lie.
Clubs of Canberra. Today we're going to show you a selection of dances based on that well-known book, The Lord of the Rings. The dances were all devised by one of our New Zealand teachers, Iain, patently a Lord of the Rings enthusiast. Our first dance is in quick time. It's a reel called Rivendell. Rivendell was the home of the elves. It was a place of quiet, learning, peace and merriment. Well, mostly peace. There is a scene in the movie where there was a discussion about who would take the ring to Mordor and destroy it. Eventually the hobbit Frodo stepped forward and declared, "I will take the ring to Mordor." And so began his quest. So look for that moment of to-ing and fro-ing in the dance that reflects the argument, but also enjoy the merriment of Rivendell.
Thank you.
attracts fame. This is the elegant, slow tempo, unique to Scottish country dance. The dance is called the Grey Wanderer, and refers, of course, to Gandalf, one of the wizards of Middle-earth who supported Frodo in his quest to destroy the One Ring. You can imagine Gandalf in his long grey cloak and tall pointy hat wandering the misty hills of Middle-earth as you watch this next dance. To that part of the movie in which our own Kate Blanchett appeared, The Vale of Singing Gold.
Thank you.
And now to something really exciting, a dance called The Riders of Rohan. Those of you who are familiar with the story will know that the riders appeared at various times of peril to rescue Frodo and his mates from the servants of the Dark Lord Sauron, the Ring's evil creator. The dance reflects the battles and chases that typify the rider's role. It was written as a result of Iain's wife challenging him to devise a really real reel. The result is a dance consisting entirely of various reels, which are of course fundamental to Scottish country dance. Listen for the horses galloping as you enjoy the Riders of Rohan. Reflects the ancient lumbering trees of Fangorn, known as the Ents. Like the riders, the Ents appeared at various times to rescue Frodo and his mates and help them defeat Sauron's evil forces. The Ents moved and spoke slowly, as reflected in the Strathspey tempo. And yes, I did say moved and spoke. It is a fantasy, after all. Thank you. different this time, a dance called the Lord of Gondor, with just two men and four women in each set. Gondor is the southern kingdom of the Men of the West, and the location of the biggest battle scene in the trilogy. The Lord of Gondor. The Lords of the Wind. It's a reference to the eagles, the greatest birds of Middle Earth, who dwelt among the high peaks of the Misty Mountains, and like the riders and ents, appeared at various times throughout the book and helped Frodo win through. Towards the end of the book, as the volcano Mount Doom was crumbling following the creation of the One Ring, Frodo and Samwise were trapped on a rocky pinnacle surrounded by rising lava. The eagles swooped in and plucked them to safety. As you watch the dance, imagine the eagles swooping through the valleys and peaks of Middle Earth. everybody for watching. We hope you have enjoyed our display. The team is now distributing flyers, yes, with information on all our Canberra classes. So if you're interested, please pick one up or come and speak to us.